It's Friday, Friday. Gotta get down on Friday. Everybody looking forward to the weekend, weekend. Friday, Friday. Getting down on Friday. Everybody looking forward to the weekend. Partying, 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 partying.
All right, so Rebecca Black. I don't need to say a lot more, right? Every blurry, low-contrast YouTube webcam commentator and their mother have commented on this Friday song, which became an overnight sensation for being a complete piece of shit. Because that's what the world rewards now. It's really sad. If you're good, even great. You know, you could end up with anywhere from a couple thousand to a few million hits, but if you're downright fucking terrible, we're talking tens of millions of views or more. But here's the thing, and I'm certainly not going to defend it. As I've said, it's a piece of shit, but it's only when you separate it from the rest of the pile that you even notice how bad it smells. Toss it in the rest of the manure pile, it smells just the same as the rest of the feces. Here's what I mean. Maybe you'll recognize some of this other genius songwriting. You should. They were all top 40 songs on Billboard, some of them even number one at one time or another.
Boom, 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 gotta get that. 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 Boom, boom, boom. That boom, 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 that boom, 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 that boom, boom, yeah.
Make me wanna say, oh, 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 oh.
Pedicure on our toes, toes. Trying on all our clothes, clothes. Boys blowing up our phones, phones. Dropped up and playing our favorite CDs. Pulling up to the parties. Trying to get a little bit tipsy.
Should have made the prisoners at Gitmo listen to that little medley. They'd have been fucking talking in seconds. You're telling me that any one of those songs were actually better than some pile of garbage written for some little girl with rich parents that bought some studio time so she could have her own pop song? That's how the story goes anyway. Arc Music Factory is a label where little girls with rich parents can go and they'll put them in a music video. I mean, check out all the rest of the videos from the same YouTube channel. They're all equally garbage. This one just happened to end up on that Tosh.0 show. I don't know, I've never seen it. I can watch YouTube without the need for a douche-looking host, thanks very much. Anyway, the thing is, the wrong audience has found this song. I mean, I would absolutely hope an adult wouldn't enjoy this. It's for kids. And as far as kiddie pop goes, this isn't even the worst example of it I've heard this year so far. Have a listen to Miranda Cosgrove. You may or may not know her as iCarly. I have no idea what that is either, but I once saw McDonald's was giving away merchandise with that slapped on it, so it must be popular with the kids. Here's a song called Dancing Crazy. I like you and you like me, we'll get together and be happy. What? Jesus cocksucking Christ, what Mensa candidate wrote that nonsense? If anything, Rebecca Black could have turned this whole thing around and looked like a genius, like the funniest woman in America, if she'd have said that Friday was actually a style parody of all pop music. A style parody isn't necessarily a specific parody of something, rather it's a parody of a number of songs or a genre as a whole. The Lonely Island essentially do style parodies of hip-hop, dance, and 80s pop songs. Weird Al's Dare to be Stupid is a perfect example of a synth-pop style parody. I'm sure there's lots of others. Anyway, had she done that, people would say, "Holy shit, that was smart as hell!" Instead, she's clinging to it as serious work, and she feels like she's being cyber-bullied because of all the negative reviews it's had. She may have never even asked for it to go viral like this. Maybe she wanted it to be just something that she could show her friends and that's that, but it happened, so now she's a public figure and subject to the same scrutiny and review as anyone else in the public eye. So yeah, auto-tuned, mundane lyrics about absolutely nothing with some crappy music and a drum machine keeping the beat? Sounds like pop to me. I'm not even going to put this on my worst 10 of 2011 because it's not even going to chart. People will forget about this and move on to the next internet fad soon. See Charlie Sheen, that 7-year-old that was playing a Lady Gaga song, that guy that played piano on Chat Roulette itself. It won't even be the next Aqua Barbie girl, something so awful we still remember it 15 or 20 years later. It's just going to fade away, only to become an obscure reference that only the lamest of internet nerds will continue to talk about.
Hey, I got this, you got this, now you know it. Kicking in the front seat, sitting in the back seat. Gotta make my mind up.